Hello, this tutorial covers some of the most common keyboard commands for managing and moving around in Blender. This tutorial was created with Blender 2.54 beta. The keyboard commands have not changed much in Blender, so commands covered here should apply to future versions of Blender as well. Blender's default starting world includes one cube. Let's add a few more cubes so that we can practice navigating around them. The cube selected, type Shift D. D stands for duplicate. You can now place the cube in a new location with a mouse. Duplicate a few more cubes with the Shift D key and place them in different spots. If you decide you not want a duplicated cube, you can hit the Escape key. But this does not, however, get rid of the cube. The duplicated cube still exists, just stacked on top of the other cube. You can click and drag on the colored arrows to see this. To delete a cube, select it and hit the X key. Then, confirm that you want to delete the cube. Remember, you can select different cubes by clicking on them with the right mouse button. The left mouse button, the button you normally click with, will not work to select cubes. Get about 5 cubes in the world so that we can learn to navigate around them. The first command to learn is the 7 key on the number pad. Pressing this key will display a top-down view of the world. If this doesn't work for you, there are a few possible reasons as to why. First, make sure that the 7 key that you're hitting is on the keypad on the right of the keyboard rather than the number keys on the top. Second, the mouse must be over the dark gray window. If the mouse is over the controls, the view will not change when you hit the number pad. The other thing that can prevent this from working is if the number lock key is turned off. On your keypad, there should be a number lock key. Pressing this key will change a light on your keyboard on and off. The light must be on for the 7 key to work. In addition to the 7 key, you can press the 1 and the 3 keys. These give the front and right view. You can see that the current view is shown in the upper left of the window. Go ahead and try this, the 1, 3, and 7 keys now, switching between the different views. Next, try the plus and minus keys. These zoom the view in and out. You can rotate the view with the 4, 6, 8, and 2 keys. The 4 and 6 keys will rotate the views left and right, and the 8 and 2 keys rotate the view up and down. You can set the view to what the camera sees by pressing the 0 key. Go ahead and try that now. The light shaded area is what the camera sees. If you press the key on the keyboard labeled F12, which is in the upper right of the keys on the keyboard, it'll render the view and you'll get your final picture. Press the Escape key to go back to the normal view that you had before. Okay, after you've pressed the Escape key, switch to the top-down view. Remember, you can do that by pressing the 7 key. Zoom in on a bit on the cubes. Do that by pressing the plus key, and then press the 5 key a few times. The 5 key toggles between a perspective view and the orthogonal view. The perspective view shows what you would actually see. The orthogonal view removes perspective. It is like looking at a straight down blueprint of a building. It is the best view to use when you need to line items up and place them in a precise location. Another very important key is the period key on the keypad. Pressing it will center the view around the object that you've selected. Here, I use the middle mouse button to rotate the view. I select a new object with the right mouse button. Press the period key, and then you can rotate around the new object. Try that several times. It is an important key to learn when navigating the 3D world in Blender. Select the object, press the period key, and then you can rotate around again. Sometimes you have several objects but only want to work with one of them. You can select the object, then press the slash key on the keypad. This will toggle a local view so that you'll only see that selected object. Pressing the slash key again will toggle back to show everything. Here are some other useful keys. If you want to move the camera to the view that you've got on the screen right now, press and hold the Alt keys down while you press the number pad 0. Give that a try. So, as you can see here, we've got the camera moved to a new location. We can try this again, moving to a new location. This is where we want the camera to see. Press Control, Alt, and the number pad 0. Our camera is now in a new location, viewing what we've got on our view screen. Now, the other thing that you can do is press the Z key in order to see basically a wireframe view of what's going on. It's like having X-ray vision. Pressing the Z key again will toggle back to the original view that you had. Pressing the T key toggles the tool shelf on the left side on and off. The N key toggles the object properties on and off. So, pressing the N key with an object selected toggles the object properties on and off. The Control Up key turns off most of the other screens, giving you a full screen view. Pressing Control Up arrow again will bring them back. Control Alt Q turns on a quad view. You get to see multiple perspectives of your object. Control Alt Q. Pressing Control Alt Q again will return you to your previous view. Pressing Shift B will allow you to select a region of the screen, and the view will automatically zoom in to only show that region. So press Shift B. You get a pair of dotted lines. You can draw a box and zoom straight in on it. Alt B will actually clip the objects, allowing you to only see part of them. Alt B works the same way, but now the objects are clipped, allowing us to see inside of it. Pressing Alt B again will return you to your normal view. Well, that's it for an introduction to some of the most common keyboard commands used in navigating the Blender views.